Peace be upon you, Altair. How may I serve you?
I've done as asked and learned all I need to know about my prey.
Then you must share your knowledge with me.
Abu Naqud is corrupt to the core and despised by his own citizens as a result. It appears he's been stealing money meant for the people of Damas and spending it on himself. Even as we speak, he flaunts his greed, preparing for a lavish party. His guards and servants should have their hands full dealing with the guests. They won't even know I'm there.
Most impressive, my friend. The others said you'd make a mess of things, but not I. No, I was sure you'd come through, and come through you have. The bureau is yours to do with as you please until you're ready to begin.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
Leave, peasant, before I make you.
Welcome, welcome. Thank you all for joining me this evening. Please eat, drink, enjoy all the pleasures I have to offer. Take your time, I will wait. I trust everything is to your satisfaction. Good, good. It pleases me to see you all so happy. For these are dark days, my friends, and we must enjoy this bounty while we still can. War threatens to consume us all. Salah ad-Din bravely fights for what he believes in, and you are always there to support him without question. It is your generosity that allows his campaign to continue. So I propose a toast then. To you, my dear friends, who have brought us to where we are today. May you be given everything you deserve for it. Such kindness! I didn't think it in you. You, who have been so quick to judge me, and so cruel. Oh, do not feign ignorance. Do you take me for a fool? That I have not heard the words you whisper behind my back. Well, I have, and I fear I can never forget. But this is not why I called you here tonight, no. I wish to speak more of this war, and your part in it. You give up your coin quick as can be, knowing all too well it buys the deaths of thousands. You don't even know why we fight. The sanctity of the Holy Land, you'll say, or the evil inclination of our enemies. But these are lies you tell yourselves. No, all this suffering is born of fear and hate. It bothers you that they are different, just as it bothers you that I am different. Compassion, mercy, tolerance. These words mean nothing to any of you, mean nothing to those infidel invaders who ravage our land in search of gold and glory. And so I say, enough! I've pledged myself to another cause, one that will bring about a new world in which all people might live side by side in peace. A pity none of you will live to see it. Kill anyone who tries to escape.
Peace now. Their words can no longer do harm.
Why have you done this?
You stole money from those you claim to lead, sent it away for some unknown purpose. I want to know where it's gone and why.
Look at me. My very nature is an affront to the people I ruled. And these noble robes did little more than to muffle their shouts of hate.
So this is about vengeance, then?
No, not vengeance, but my conscience. How could I finance a war in service to the same god that calls me an abomination?
If you do not serve Salah ad-Din's cause, then whose?
In time, you'll come to know them. I think perhaps you already do.
Then why hide? And why these dark deeds?
Is it so different from your own work? You take the lives of men and women, strong in the conviction that their deaths will improve the lots of those left behind. A minor evil for a greater good? We are the same.
No, we are nothing alike.
Ah, but I see it in your eyes. You doubt. You cannot stop us. We will have our new world.
Yeah.
Word has reached me of your success, Altair.
Abu Nakud's reign of terror is at an end. I'm glad to hear it. He killed them. The men and women at his party. It was poison. A coward's tool. Blamed them for the war. Said he wished to end it.
Strange, but then again, the Merchant King was known to be a bit different. Perhaps this was simply a symptom of his madness.
Perhaps.
You sound unconvinced. Speak with Al-Mualim then. He may offer a better explanation.
Yes, we'll see what he has to say.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
You say, Doc.
I'm ending the session. I'll be right there. You're sure about this?
Yes.
No. Everything's Denver. I don't see how he could... Of course. I understand. You're in a lot of trouble, Mr. Miles.
What's his problem?
They're coming for you.
Who's coming for me?
Assassins.
Hey, I had nothing to do with this.
Sounds like they're mounting some kind of rescue attempt. Guess you're more important than you realized.
Man, things just keep getting weirder and weirder around here.
It was bound to happen.
What do you mean?
That little fight your ancestor started during the Third Crusade, it never ended. You're being held by Templars.
Vidic's a Templar?
There's no way you could have known. They hide it so well. But to answer your question... Vidic works for them. We all do. Abstergo is their company.
I thought Templars were old dudes with funny hats who sat around drinking beer and plotting world domination with, like, the lizard people.
No. Except the part about world domination, I guess. Look, Desmond, it's complicated. Half the stuff they say about the Templars comes from crazy tinfoil hat-wearing nutjobs. The other half is misinformation intentionally produced by the Templars themselves.
But they are the bad guys, right?
If there's one thing I've learned since I started working here, it's that there's no such thing. It's all so relative. I guess the best way to explain it is, what they want is good. But the way they're going about it, it's bad. Really bad.
What are they trying to do? Lucy...
Yes.
Miss Dillon, I need to speak with you. Get up here, now.
On my way, Doctor. I'm sorry, Desmond, I have to go. You should turn in for the night. The answers to all of your questions are right in front of you. You just have to know where to look.
Missed you this morning, Doc.
Get in the Animus.
Time to start the program, Desmond.
The short blade is best for quickly fending off multiple enemies.
Come in, Altair. I trust you are well rested. Ready for your remaining trials?
I am, but I'd speak with you first. I have questions.
Ask then. I'll do my best to answer.
The merchant king of Demas murdered the nobles who ruled his city. Mejdedin in Jerusalem used fear to force his people into submission. I suspect William meant to murder Richard and hold Akka with his troops. These men were meant to aid their leaders. Instead, they chose to betray them. What I do not understand is why.
Is the answer not obvious? The Templars desire control. Each man, as you've noted, wanted to claim their cities in the Templar name, that the Templars themselves might rule the Holy Land, and eventually beyond. But they cannot succeed in their mission.
Why is that?
Their plans depend upon the Templar treasure, the Peace of Eden. But we hold it now, and they cannot hope to achieve their goals without it.
What is this treasure?
It is temptation.
It's just a piece of silver.
Look at it.
What am I supposed to see?
This piece of silver cast out Adam and Eve. It turned staves into snakes, parted and closed the Red Sea. Ares used it to start the Trojan War, and with it a poor carpenter turned water into wine.
It seems rather plain for all the power you claim it has. How does it work?
He who holds it commands the hearts and minds of whoever looks upon it. Whoever tastes of it, as they say.
Then Gagne's men?
An experiment. Herbs used to simulate its effects, to be ready for when they held it.
Talel supplied them. Tamir equipped them. They were preparing for something. But what?
War.
And the others, the men who ruled the cities. They meant to gather up their people. Make them like Gagne's men.
The perfect citizens. The perfect soldiers. A perfect world.
Robert de Sable must never have this back.
So long as he and his brothers live, they will try.
Then they must be destroyed.
Which is what I've had you doing. There are two more Templars who require your attention. One in Akka, known as Sibran. One in Damas, called Jubair. Visit with the Bureau leaders. They'll instruct you further.
As you wish.
Be quick about it. No doubt Robert de Sable is made nervous by our continued success. His remaining followers will do their best to expose you. They know you come, the man in the white hood. They'll be looking for you.
They won't find me. I'm but a blade in the crowd.
Here, my gift to you, in gratitude for the good work you've done.
When you have been exposed, killing some of your pursuers will make it easy.
Greetings, Altair. What news?
Al-Muallim has named another. Calls himself Sabrand.
I am familiar with the man. Newly appointed leader of the Knights Teutonic, he resides in the Venetian Quarter and runs Akka's port.
I'll start my work at once.
Here are the places where you should focus your search. On the docks east of here, among the ships and their crews. At the chapel to the northeast, near the cross overlooking the port. And to the north, in front of St. John's Gate.
This is most helpful. My thanks for the guidance.
Altair.
Yes, Rafik.
I owe you an apology.
For what?
For doubting your dedication to our cause.
No, it was I who erred. I believe myself above the creed. You owe me nothing.
As you wish, my friend. Go in safety.
Enough!